I'm Greg Hollows. Welcome to the Imaging Lab. In this segment, we're going to look at backlights. We're going to look at specifically diffuse types of backlights like I have here. As you can see, this is a very large area backlight. It's about 4x8. And what an area backlight does is allows us to get a silhouetted image, though it's a little tough to see here because we have some front illumination on the lens that we have in front of the light. But what it does is allows us to create a silhouetted image to look at an object, to measure its size or look for defects that might be if it's a part that's supposed to be stamped or machined that would have some extra pieces hanging onto it that weren't totally cleaned off in a cleaning process, or to do other things where a silhouetted image would give us lots of good information. Now, some of the things that we need to understand about these is that they are an awful lot of energy goes into them. There's quite a few LEDs around the inside. But being a diffuse light in and of itself, this diffuser gives us a nice wide angle of light coming off of here. What that does for us, it gets us even illumination over a large area, which can be very, very beneficial in many ways. Now, one of the problems that we can run into with this is as we move and we're looking at a highly reflective part, as you can see in the image that's being shown here, you will actually get some soft edges on the object. The object will go from a silhouetted, very dark image that's here, and it'll roll off as we go to the edge of the light. The reason for that is, again, if you look in the next image, there's a certain amount of angular diffusion that's going on here out of these lights. So while light is being blocked that's immediately behind the object, we're getting some angular light here that's hitting the edges and being scattered towards the camera system, and that's allowing us to pick up a softer edge on the object. That could be good, that could be bad. It depends on the critical nature of the application and how well we have to see that absolute edge on the object. Now we're going to have a segment coming up that's on a little bit more advanced illumination that'll let you actually see how to eliminate those issues if that's critical to you. But for this example, being able to make a nice silhouetted image can get done very, very easily with one of these large lights. Now, the other nice things about it is they're fairly slim. They don't take up a lot of space. They can fit right behind something on a manufacturing line, and they will be compact. That is a nice feature of them. The one downside is that if you start to move them too far away from the object, the amount of intensity relative to the object itself goes down very, very quickly. So they have to be very, very close to what you're looking at generally. And being that they're so diffuse, not as much light as you would hope would necessarily make it up to the optics in all cases, and this can be a problem. They come in a variety of different wavelengths and feature sets, but they are very, very effective for doing silhouetted images. That is backlights. You can click on any of the links to take you to the other lighting areas that you're interested in or any of the other imaging topics of your choice.